Welcome to H2K Infosys. H2K Infosys is an e-verify business based in Atlanta, Georgia, United States. We provide 100% job-oriented, instructor-led, face-to-face, true live online software training programs. It also includes access to cloud test lab with software tools. We provide live project for you to work on. We also provide assistance with mock interviews, resume preparation and review, and job placement assistance. H2K Infosys is trusted by so many students across the world. H2K Infosys provides world-class services in IT training with real-time project work for corporates and individuals, special IT training for MS students in the United States, software design, development, QA manual and automation, performance testing and maintenance, IT staff augmentation, job placement assistance and tech support.
Text box belongs to the edit class, button belongs to the button class, checkbox belongs to the checkbox class, radio button belongs to the radio button class. Okay, do you see? All the objects are belonging to the one or the other classes. Clear, Lavanya? Okay, Prerna, I will unmute you. You ask your question, please. Hold on. One second. Okay, Prerna, go ahead, please ask your question.
Okay, please ask your question.
My question is, you told us right now that if we manually code the script, then in the object repository, the QA has to make the entry for all the objects that has been used in the coding. But I'm assuming that, let's say, if I create any script and manually, but then when I run it, then object repository, won't it be created automatically?
No. Objects are created during the recording, not during the execution.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Yeah. Thank you.
Okay. So, Madhu has a question. Are there any customized object classes and type of operation? Yes. See here, Madhu, this date of flight, it is a customized object, and all the customized object, they belong to the object class by default. They do not have separate classes. All of them belong to one common class. The name itself is the object class. Okay. Yes, Lavanya. Wait, let me unmute you. You can ask your question. One second. Okay, Lavanya. Go ahead, please.
Yeah, Priya, my question is, can you go to the next slide?
Okay, one second. Which is your next slide? This one?
Yeah, here, the class, right?
Mm-hmm.
The one which is before the last one, the class.
Mm-hmm.
So, I'm stuck there only. Could you please tell me about the class in regards to the login window?
Sure. See, basically, what is a class? It is a group, right?
Mm-hmm.
That is clear for you?
Yeah, that is clear. No, I'm talking about in regards to the
properties.
The login
window. Okay. I'll come to that. What is a property? Property is anything using which we can identify. Correct?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. For example, how do we identify you? Basically, based on your voice, okay, on your look, right? And the different things, okay? If I see your handwriting, okay, I can say this is belonging to you. So those are properties, okay? Using which I can identify you. That is property. Now, you were asking me regarding the login. Okay. So what exactly
mm-hmm.
to which class it belongs? Login belongs to which class? Is that your question?
No. The class here, what kind of classes do we have?
The
in the login window.
In the login window, you want the classes.
Yeah.
In the login window, there are no classes. They are objects. Okay. You can only see the objects over here, which will be belonging to the class. Agent name, this is an object. All these are objects. Okay. These are not the classes. Okay. And all these text boxes, it could be the agent name, password, you take any text box, whether it is in the flight reservation login window or it is in any other web application, all the text boxes belong to the same class, that is edit class.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. So you cannot say, you know, okay. like, yeah, agent name, it is, no. See, all the objects belong to a one common class that we can say. Okay.
No, I was thinking this agent name and password and everything belongs to one class, so that like it's like it comes into the login class or something mm-hmm. like that. No, correct me if I'm wrong.
It doesn't come under the login class, it comes under the edit class because it is a text box.
Okay, can you go into the login window?
Yeah, this is a login window, right?
No. After this, the flight application.
Okay, this one?
Yeah. See, here I was thinking like the flight from and flight to and date of flight all belongs to the flight class.
No.
Including the flight number, departure,
no,
arrival
no.
time and everything.
It is
the name and...
No.
Okay.
You have, you know, got it completely wrong. So you are assuming that all these belong to the flight reservation class. Flight reservation is not a class, first of all. Okay? Here, fly from and fly to belong to a class called as combo box. Okay? Both of these
okay.
are combo boxes.
Okay.
So, these both belong to the combo box class. Okay?
So, then, you are dividing them on basis of their property.
Exactly.
Okay.
All these radio
okay.
buttons. Okay? We have three radio buttons. The three radio buttons belong to
okay.
a class called as radio button. Okay.
Oh, okay.
You
okay,
have this
okay.
name text box. It belongs to the class called as edit. You have update order, delete
okay.
order, insert order, flight, then all these buttons, all of them, they belong to the button class.
Oh, okay.
It is like this. Okay. Flight reservation is not a class. It is just a window. In fact, flight reservation belongs to a class called as window.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
So they are basically grouped and in accordance with the property.
Properties, yes, exactly.
Okay, got it.
Okay.
Thank you, Priya.
You're welcome. Okay, so Madhu has a question. How do we differentiate standard and customized class? See, Madhu, if you are able to define it, it is a standard class. If you are unable to define, like, you know, date of flight, date can be entered in many ways, okay? Now, this has been totally customized by our developer. But combo box, developer cannot do any changes here, okay? You take any combo box, you consider any developer, he is going to do it in the same way. But the date can be put in any format. For example, he has taken underscore and then slash. Somebody could have taken a dash or a hyphen, right? So, it depends. But even looking at the script, we can identify the property of the object. Sorry, the class of the object, which I will be telling you later. Okay. Then. Rupa has a question. Date of flight belongs to the date class. No, Rupa. Date of flight is a customized object. So it should belong to what class? Object class. Not the date. There is no class called as date. Okay. Saujanya has a question. Is logo an object? Yes. Logo is also an object. It belongs to the image class. Then, flight number belongs to which class? Where is your flight number? Oh, this one, flight number. This is a text box actually, which is disabled. Correct, Prerna? Flight number is nothing but it is a text box, but it is disabled. It has a different property. I mean, property value. Correct? So, this is also a text box which belongs to the edit class again. Okay? Fine. Okay, so more about this I'll be, telling. Okay, Prerna, you are confused still. Is it clear or not? Okay, I will unmute you. Hold on. Why are you getting confused? It is so simple. Okay, tell me, what is your confusion?
Yeah, Priya, I'm very clear with this. Like, it's a text box and it is a editable like name, so it belongs to the edit class, which is pretty clear to me. But I'm talking about this flight number, which is again a text box, but it is non-editable. So it doesn't match the property of a text box which is editable and which belongs to edit class. So I'm confused with that. How can it be? It belongs.
See,
to
I will
edit
do
class.
One thing. I'll take a very very common example. Okay. Wait. Okay, we will take each one of you. Okay, like we have Prerna, then we have Lavanya, we have Dinesh, and then who else is there? Okay, Swarna is there. All the different participants over here. Okay, so all of you belong to which class? The common class. Let me name it as like human beings, okay, more generalized rather than QA participants. Okay, now each one of you are going to have the common properties. What are the common properties? All of you can read. These are your properties. Okay, all of you are nothing but, let's say, you all are objects. Okay, and this is your class. To a common class you're belonging. You can read, you can write, you can talk. Okay, you can understand. These are your properties. But the values are going to be, different. Some people can read very fast. Some people can, like, Prerna talks very fast, right? She talks very fast. Okay. Swarna is going to talk very slow. She has a very soft voice. Writing, okay. Prerna is little bit slow in writing, but Lavanya is very fast in writing. Okay. Understanding. Okay, Prerna is, like having a medium speed of understanding. Lavanya understands slow. Dinesh understands fast. Like this, properties are going to be the same. Values are going to be the different. Okay, for example, what you said, like, the flight number. Okay, it belongs to the class. Okay, let me put it here. So flight is what? It is an object, right? Flight number. It belongs to a class called as edit. What are the properties it has? Enabled is a property. Okay, then text value that it has is a property. The label is a property. The values are changing. Enabled is false, that's why you are able to see it disabled. Text is, there is no text over here, so this is nothing. Label is basically the flight number, correct? Focused, it is not focused, so it is false, correct? Properties are going to be the same, values are going to change. Okay, similarly, that's why the flight number over here, it is still an object. It belongs to the edit class, but it is having the value for the disabled equal to, sorry, enabled equal to false. Okay, is that clear, Prerna? Now are you getting? Okay. Yeah. Okay, then so we will do one thing. It is very clear. Yeah, I know. If we take a real-time example, that would be good, But then, I hope so. When you go to your interview, don't give this kind of examples when you are asked to answer it, okay? Take the examples that are relevant to your software. Don't give this kind of common examples. That's why I hesitate a bit, to give you such kind of common example. I see some people, they go and they give the same example to the interviewer. Don't do that, okay? Don't give any common examples to your interviewer. Okay, image, well, Angelina, whether image is disabled or enabled, I don't know. There is some person over here who is going to tell you that. Okay, now if you want to know, there are a lot of properties, okay, just by seeing the object, I cannot judge as a tester what are the properties, what are the property values. Immediately, I can't judge, okay, but there is a person who is going to do it for you. You know who is that? I will introduce to that person in the next class. He is called as an object spy, okay, who is present in our QTP. It is basically a tool by, object spy that will identify the object properties for us and also the values of those properties, okay. So, I will introduce him to you in the next session. So, this much is enough for today, okay. Okay. Saujanya, for object repository, we should go to Dinesh computer. Let's go to his computer. Okay, Dinesh, can you please share your screen for a moment? Okay, can you show the object repository? Okay, show it to Saujanya, okay? Show the object repository. Do you see Saujanya, the object repository on his screen? Okay. Okay, and what is an object repository? It is a location wherein we can, where the objects and the object properties are stored. We call it as a object repository. Clear, everybody? Okay. All right then. So let's close the session for today. And whoever has the installation pending, only the people who have installation pending can stay back. Others can, you know, just go on with your practices. Tomorrow we will be meeting in the session. Okay. Sure. Okay. Who needs help? Okay. One by one. Okay. We will take one by one. I will help everybody, but like one by one. Okay. Hold please. Okay. Swarna, what kind of help? Is it the installation help or what is it? Delete order. Okay. Okay, Madhu. Can we do one thing? Can we take your doubts tomorrow? Is that okay? So that, you know, we complete the installation today. Otherwise, it's going to take a lot of time. Again, tomorrow also we'll get interrupted. Okay? Fine. And please do not forget your questions. Your questions, make sure you write it in a notepad and keep it. Tomorrow I'm going to ask you, what is your doubt you got to ask me, okay? Yes, Lata, I'm uploading, I will send it to you, okay? So whoever has the installation pending, you can, just hold on, don't quit the session, one second. Okay, whoever has the installation pending, okay, you can stay back in the session and others can quit the session, okay?
So many of our students have given testimonials on how our training programs are. You will find them on kudzu.com and on our website, h2kinfosys.com. On our website h2kinfosys.com, you will also find more detailed information on who we are, the courses that we offer, what each course covers. Also, if you're interested in a demo program, please register on our homepage on the left hand side. Just give us more information about yourself and we will send you a link for a demo class. The demo class is absolutely free. Experience our commitment by just attending an orientation workshop at no cost. Our team of faculty and advisors are here to guide you with the right information. If you still have more questions, please feel free to call us. Call us at 770-777-1269. This is a United States number. If you're calling from the UK, call us at 020-337-17615. You can also email us at training@h2kinfosys.com or h2kinfosys@gmail.com. Thank you for watching our videos. We wish you a great career in information technology.